There are various colors of engine coolant available, such as orange and green. Are these kinds interchangeable, or is there a distinction between orange and green coolant? In this video, we look at how each coolant type works and discuss whether you should mix the two coolants together. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. What is coolant? Coolant is antifreeze that has been mixed with water to protect the vehicle. In addition to preventing freezing, coolant maintains the engine's operating temperature safely. The antifreeze mixture is mixed with equal parts water to make most coolants. Water can cool the engine on its own, but it isn't as efficient. Water actually has the ability to freeze in colder climates and evaporate when the engine gets too hot. Your engine is susceptible to damage in both of these situations. The dyes used to make the coolant give it its color. To make sure you know which dye to use, manufacturers incorporate a specific dye into the mixture. Green and orange are the two coolant colors that are most well known. Differences between green and orange coolant. Green coolant. This engine coolant was created especially for older, pre-2000s cars. Systems built with steel and copper are fitted with green coolant. The metallic components are shielded from rust and corrosion by the green composition. Inorganic additive technology is added to the mixture within the composition. IAT is made up of various substances, including silicone and phosphate combined with propylene and ethylene glycol. Phosphates are derived from phosphoric acid and are used to soften water and remove oil and grease. Silicones serve as a metal sealant, protecting the materials from deterioration brought on by moisture, chemicals, and wear. One way to prevent engine temperatures is to use ethylene or propylene glycol. Orange coolant. Orange antifreeze is not recommended for use on cars with a lot of metal in them, but it does aid in protecting against corrosion and wear. Rather, it is utilized on more recent models composed of aluminum and nylon. Carboxylates, found in the orange coolant, act to lessen corrosion. Unlike green coolant, these materials do not harm the non-metallic components. In the 1990s, systems began to be constructed using less steel and copper. At that point, GM introduced X-Cool, a product that combines organic acid technologies to lessen rust occurrences. When the coolant level falls too low, orange coolant does let oxygen into the system. This flaw causes clogs and internal component damage. That's why it's important to keep the system filled up at all times. Is it okay to mix coolant types? No, it is never a good idea to combine green and orange coolant. A chemical reaction happens when the two come together, causing thickening that shouldn't happen. All that's left is a gel that doesn't function the same way as a liquid. Numerous issues will arise because this gel can't properly cycle through the system. The system will overheat and potentially fail catastrophically if it is not cooled down adequately. For instance, take the price of replacing your car's water pump. The average cost to replace a water pump is between $450 and $700, and it's much more expensive than just flush and refill your coolant system with original antifreeze. How often should coolant be flushed? To guarantee a lengthy engine life, it's critical to maintain the cooling system at peak performance. One step in system maintenance is to top off the coolant when levels get low. Nonetheless, there are instances in which a coolant flush is required. There isn't a universally agreed-upon period of time for coolant flushing. Nonetheless, the owner's manual will contain the suggested interval for your car. You can also get a printout of the maintenance schedule, which includes the ideal time for coolant flush service, from the dealership. More recent coolant formulations are longer lasting, with a working life of up to 100,000 miles or 5 years, whichever comes first. Alternatively, you may want to use a set of test strips from your neighborhood auto parts store to determine the coolant's integrity. You can check if the pH has risen too high and needs to be flushed by just dipping one into the coolant reservoir. A coolant flush involves draining the entire system of old fluid and adding a cleaner to get rid of any potentially harmful impurities. After flushing out this cleaner, fresh fluid is added, which is a 50-50 mixture of water and antifreeze. Hope the information was helpful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.